It's Fran, broadcasting from the shapeless void that is the remainders of FranLab 2.0. I'm still stuck in here, like, for the office and basic living quarters until the new space is ready. It's going to be a few more weeks. I'm over there every day, setting up shelves and unpacking boxes and organizing things, making room for the rest of the fixtures and tables and such to be able to go over there. I've been posting pictures in the community section of the channel, showing the progress with doing all that. And it's just going to be a few more weeks. We're in the middle of February, so the weather is not helping. We had a blizzard come through, and it's all just slushy, freezing mess out there, and it's just like the worst kind of conditions to have to lug things back and forth between the two spaces. But between the weather and everything, I'm making progress over there. One of the things that really perturbs me is they don't get really great shots of rocket launches anymore, for the most part. I have seen some independent, like smaller rocket companies that kind of go out of their way to get some really beautiful shots of their rockets taken off or doing test fires and stuff. But SpaceX being the biggest, they don't really put any kind of like love into the idea of documenting their launches. In fact, typically for the Falcon launches, even the Falcon Heavy launches, they don't have any cameras like on the pad. In fact, there really isn't like a pad the way that they do it. Unlike the Apollo era, where they had clusters of cameras, dozens of engineering cameras on the pad, you know, shooting at the rocket from above, the side, below. it was a totally different world. I mean, granted, those beautiful shots that we have all come to love of the Saturns, those shots from underneath the rocket exhaust and the close-up shots in the ring of cameras that was right on the pad and shots of the umbilicals pulling away and all that stuff, those things really weren't intended to be seen by regular people. In fact, when the NASA engineers designed those cameras and those mounts and installed them, it was really meant to document the processes of launching the rocket to make sure that if anything went wrong, that they would, you know, get a high speed, you know, high resolution camera footage of it happening, whatever it was, and they would be able to, you know, reverse engineer a disaster. It's really the reason that they put those cameras there to begin with. There really wasn't supposed to be like the beauty shot of the montage of the engineering cameras. After it became clear that that's really where the money was, that people really wanted to see those shots, it's just strange that it hasn't translated into the 21st century. Now, NASA, they were still using film well into like the late shuttle era. And you can find on YouTube some examples of some just tremendously great footage that was shot, even of the shuttle, of the engine startup and everything. But a modern like Falcon launch, they don't put the cameras too close, although there have been mishaps with cameras that are closest to the rockets not faring very well. They don't put the cameras close to the rocket. They're using telescopic lenses. And when the blast wave, the acoustic blast wave from the rocket finally hits those cameras, it just comes like a wobbly jello. Everything turns into rubber. And of course you have the issues with the rolling shutter and everything. But until they actually switch away to the distant telescopic cameras, it's just a shaky mess. And I guess it comes down to the idea of having really expensive, high-speed, high-resolution cameras right under a rocket exhaust inside of even more expensive blast-proof enclosures just to get those beauty shots. It's just, I guess it just doesn't like come in as a priority. But when I look back at those amazing shots they took of the Saturns, it even today, like 50 years later, it is those shots, like close up to the rocket, those slow motion, intense shots right up against the F1s and looking underneath and looking down at the exhaust and just looking at the intense power of those machines slowed down. It's those shots that really just ring out as like the real document of the awesomeness of those machines. And there's really nothing like that today. I really wish that they would consider shooting film for rocket launches, at least something to archive, something that could be preserved and put in a vault and like be seen in 100 years or 200 years, unlike the video, which who knows if it'll even exist in a century. It would be weird if hundreds of years from now, if people still had the footage, could see the footage of Saturn launches, but that no record existed anywhere of a Falcon Heavy launch. It would be weird, but very possible, because when we switched from the photochemical era to the totally digital era, we gave up archiving visuals. But I really wish that they would bring back film for doing the rocket launches. If for nothing else, to have like a really hard-mounted, very steady platform with a really heavy camera in it, like mounted in a brick of concrete, like they used to do, to get a really steady, high-speed image of the rocket taking off. It's just not a priority, I guess. It's weird that Elon Musk, he's such a technocrat. The idea that anything the old way is just stupid and we shouldn't do it. But, you know, I would think that being like the biggest space nerd on the planet, that he would have an affinity for those Apollo beauty shots of the Saturns, and you'd think he'd want to have his own version of that, but it just doesn't seem to be a priority, you know. But anyway, they'll never do it. They won't be bringing back film for rocket launches, although I wish they would. You know, with Starship coming up, that's going to be... It's like, I hope that just no one's going to see this video. Certainly no one at SpaceX is going to see this video, my little video. But if I had a wish, it would be that somebody at SpaceX who is in charge of actually doing the cameras might see this video and consider putting some 16 millimeter high-speed motion picture cameras in proper like blast housings and such, and put them right under the frickin' rocket for the Starship launches and the Super Heavy, because you're gonna want to have that on film for posterity. I'll be back. I'll probably, like a couple weeks, I'm going to have some downtime in between doing this and that. And, so maybe I'll do some other ramblings, if anybody wants to hear them. Thanks to the patrons for continuing to sponsor this channel, even though I'm not making any content through the move, but, you know, we will eventually get over there, at the end of February. We'll be properly in the new digs and should have some stuff to shoot. I've got projects and stuff to show you in the queue. So as soon as I'm like able to, I'll get back to doing that content. I just hope that when we actually do get back to doing that content, that there will be people to watch it. It won't just be crickets, but we'll just have to see. All right. I'll see you around real soon. Bye! That's where I work. Thank you.
It's what you're watching. Friend love. It's what I'm doing. Working at the bench again. I'm Fran.